Hello, so welcome to the third and probably final video about mini notation during mini notation week. Saying that, we will return to the mini notation later in the series of lessons. But I think we've already covered a lot. The last video was pretty detailed, and I'll leave some things till later. To recap, let's just go through those revision tasks that I put at the end of the last worksheet. So the idea was that we took these things and made them shorter. So this one, there's a repeating snare on the same metrical level, i.e. these are all steps as part of the same sequence. And so what we want to do is repeat the snare. And we can do that like this, which will just repeat the previous step. We could also do it like this, which just explicitly says repeat this twice. But we don't need that to there, because repeating it twice as a default, because if we wanted to repeat it three times, we could do this or this. No, I got that wrong. So that's four repeats, including the original. So, yeah. Okay. So that's the answer for that, just to do that. For this, it's on a lower metrical level, so these snares are one step. So you get a kick that's a step, and then this subsequence, which fits in one step. So each of these last half as long as each of these. And we can do that simply by multiplying to speed up the frequency of that. So that's it. You don't have to put these in, you can do, it'll automatically kind of treat that single step as a sort of subsequence and speed up, so it plays twice. This, there's like a repeating kick snare pattern, so we can do this. It's repeated three times, including the original. So now those two are the same. Again, we can also either, you don't have to put the number, you can just put an exclamation mark for each repeat. So do it that way. That's maybe slightly shorter. With this, it's trying to get you to use this. So this means take one every cycle. This is the same because there's three steps, and it's slowing it down by three, so you only get one per cycle as well. So they are the same. Right, this is trying to get you to use musical feet. Like this, so instead of having subsequences with the square brackets, you're just marking out the sort of dividing points between them, which I call musical feet. It's like the regular pulse of the rhythm. It sounds quite uneven because sometimes there's three, sometimes there's four. There's two, there's four steps, and so, but each one of those groups lasts the same amount of time. You could have gone further and sort of done some of this sort of thing. Yeah, I think that would be the same. Yeah, I think that would be like that, actually. There's this one. So what I thought this was going to be was something like this. but I was wrong. They sound different. In this example, this happens faster and that's slower. So in this, each step here is the same duration. So you end up with a kind of seven step pattern. But in this example, that's not working. This ends up being twice as long as this. because we have a subsequence here of kick, snare. So that's one step with two elements in it that we're repeating. So that doesn't work. And it's not really possible to reduce this with the syntax that I gave you. But there is one extra thing we can do, which is use a new operator called, which is this at symbol. And this basically says, make this step half as long. So it's changing its duration by this factor, which is a half. And then each step should be equal in duration. So sorry about that. I set an impossible task for you. But it is actually possible just with this extra thing. This is quite handy. And later on, I'll make a video about escaping the grid. So in a lot of examples, it's sort of 4-4. But there's lots of ways in which you can have more flexible tempos. And this is one of them. You can have really uneven things going on. But we'll return to that in a later video, not as part of mini notation week. I realise I can't find it quite hard to say mini notation. Maybe we need to come up with a more easily pronounced word for that. So this one is a bit more straightforward. It's just a case of kick snare repeated in a step. So that's just a case of doing this. So we've got kick snare fitting into a step and then speeding up by a factor of three, so you get three repeats of it. Yeah, that's better. And this final one, let's have a look. So that is repeating this four times and then making this repeat three times, but within the step, so on that lower metrical level. Okay, so the next thing, the last thing I'd like to cover during mini notation week is Euclidean syntax. So this is quite a fun thing. Before I do that, I'll show you how to update Tidal, because last night I released a new version of Tidal, version 1.4.9, which includes a nice little function called draw, which I think is useful for doing things like understanding the Euclidean syntax. So if I bring up this is going to be the same procedure more or less, depending on every operating system. On a Mac, you might find that you need to do this first, which will just make sure that the Haskell commands are available. And then you do kabal update. So this will update kabal, which is the thing that looks after all the Haskell packages, including Tidal, which you might well have come across when you install Tidal. This can take a little while sometimes, but that was quite quick. And then you do kabal install tidal hyphen hyphen lib. If this doesn't work, if it seems like it doesn't understand that command, then that's because you're on a slightly older version of Haskell. Don't worry about it. In that case, you run it without the lib. but most of you will need that lib there. Otherwise, it might look as if it's installed, but it hasn't. I don't know why you need this parameter. It's completely beyond me, but it's something they added that you have to put it, otherwise it doesn't work. And you just run that and let that run through. I've already got it installed, so won't that run. I'll just go back to Atom. Here it is. Okay. And then once you've installed it, if you've already got Tidal running, you'll need to go to Tidal Cycles, reboot Tidal Cycles, just to make sure you're on the new version. And then if you want to make doubly sure, you can do Tidal underscore version here. And it should say 1.4.9 if you're on the latest one. Right, so Euclidean notation. So this is named after Euclidean algorithm, which is, I think, the first algorithm that was ever written down in one of Euclid's books of elements. Also, the story goes, I'm a bit skeptical about this really, but there's this idea that this way of generating rhythms is somehow has the same kind of procedure as Euclid came up with his first algorithm, which I think was for originally calculating lowest common multiple or something like that. Anyway, let's put that to one side. It's kind of nice that it is connected to the first ever algorithm in some way. So this is what a Euclidean algorithm looks like. Let's just listen to that. there's a list of these numbers. You can find this also in the tutorial on TidalCycles.org. So that is the Cuban Tresillo pattern, according to Toussaint. So let's try a different one. Have a listen to 4-9, which is from Turkey. Let's listen with a slightly easier to hear sound. Or let's try 5-9. And so on. So you can explore these numbers for yourself. It's really interesting how just with two numbers you can really explore a huge space of rhythms. So how are these actually working? Well, we can use this draw function to have a look. So let's have a look at 712 to start with. So here's what it's drawn. It's just done it with text. This is what it's produced. And you can see this has 12 steps in it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And 7 of those have been filled in with X's. And that's what the algorithm is doing. It's makes a sequence with this number of steps, but only 7 of those actually filled in with the events. And the event that it's filled in with is whatever you put here. So here it's making a step with 12 steps in, a sequence with 12 steps in, and there are 7 claps in it. So you often hear people use this one a lot, 3-8, which it doesn't draw the end, so you have to kind of highlight it to see if there's any spaces at the end. And that's what it's drawn. But what it's actually doing, it tries to fill these in as evenly as possible. So if it was something like 939, it would do that perfectly. It would end up with this, because you can fit 3 events over 9 steps completely equally. So each one of these has got, it goes X, then there's 2 spaces, X, 2 spaces, X, 2 spaces. So it's really easy to distribute 3 over 9 steps. But if it with 8, then you can't do it, because you can't evenly divide 8 by 3, and so it doesn't quite manage to do it, but it does its best job. So the whole idea of Euclidean algorithms is exploring these spaces where the number of events don't quite evenly fit into the number of steps. And so you get this sort of rhythm which is kind of regular, but then always skips a bit. So anything where the number doesn't quite fit into the... If I put 8, it'll just sound like a straight beat. But if I put 5 up to a point, it sounds as if it's regular, but then there's this kind of extra gap because it can't quite distribute them. And it turns out that a lot of rhythms can be described in this way. How significant you think that is, I don't know. A nice thing about this is that you can actually pattern these numbers as well. So if you remember the angle brackets, you can actually use those here. So I could switch between 3 events and 5 events spread over S16. So... And there's also... And you can add a third parameter, which is kind of shifting the sequence to this number of steps to the right. So let's have a look at that drawn. So here we've got this pattern, but then if I shift it by 1, then... Oh, it's gone in that direction. So what was at the start is now at the end, and the other two have shifted one step to the left. So that won't actually sound any difference on its own. So when I do this, that's the same as that. And if I shift it by 2, you'll hear it on the change. But then it carries on as it was before. But if you hear it against something else, it will sound different. You need to have that figure ground thing going on. So once I change that, it'll sound different against that other rhythm. So all of these things you can pattern. Sounds interesting. So that's that. Play around with these patterns, the simple ones, and then see how far you get with exploring ways of patterning the Euclidean numbers. Okay, this has probably been quite a long video. Sorry about that. It'll take me a while to subtitle it, but never mind. So tomorrow morning, so I say this on Friday the 17th, so on Saturday the 18th, 9 a.m. BST, I'll be talking with Lucy Heavy Lifting about live coding, and you're very welcome to join us and ask questions. If you're asleep or busy, then there'll be an archive, check what time that is in your time zone. If you click through to the YouTube video on the forum, it'll say on the countdown there what the local time is for you. It's going to be at 9 a.m., but the next video I'll try and make it at 9 p.m. so that people in different parts of the world will be able to join. Hopefully you won't be asleep for both 9 a.m. and 9 p.m. That would be quite a long sleep, but if that's what you do, that's fine. Okay, until next time, bye!